Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classroom. In our last lecture, we were discussing related to the adsorption. We already know that in our next lecture, we will discuss related to colloids. Now, what is the colloids? Colloids means what? Actually, it's a type of solution. Right? Now, this is not an homogeneous solution. It's going to form heterogeneous. That means here the adsorption process is not going to take place between the two components, but the size. Here we are going to depend upon the size of particles present in the solution. Now, particularly this colloid, they are going to form heterogeneous. Heterogeneous solution, right? And for that reason, because of this reason, we remove that solution and we use the word sole for it now. In place of solution, we use sole. Homogeneous solution, heterogeneous sole, not solution, right? What is the difference here? What is the difference between this? We are having it as a true solution. Suspended solution, and now we are having it as a colloids, the third term that we want to study, right? All the three you have studied it in the lower standard also, you are aware about it, you have seen the different types, and in your daily routine life also you are seeing those things. But today we will try to understand what is it, right? When we are having true solution, less than 1 mm, the size of the adsorbent, the size of the particle, the size of the solute that is dissolved in the solvent, the size of the solute is a very, very small, it's less than 1 nm, right? This means if I try to filter, nothing will come out as a residual, everything will be filtered out. For this, if I take it as an example of NaCl, if NaCl is added to the water, now you know it that a large quantity of a bunch of NaCl is added to it, and you have been told that now separate that NaCl. Can you go it by the filtration process? Can you say that if I filter it, and NaCl will be separated and water will be separated? No, we can't. Okay, you after adding that salt, if you have been told, just check how much salt particles and where are they, and can see the salt particles? Answers are, we can't see the salt particles present. Even we can't see where they are moving it. They are just separated and they are can't be observed. Solution looks clear. Clear solution. Transparent solution. Right? Then such type of solutions are known as true solution. So if I am being asked to write a difference, I can put this point. Difference, the first point I will put it, size is less than 1 nanometer for the solutes. It's a clear solution. You can say that cannot be separated by filtration. They can be separated by some other physical, chemical methods, but not by filtration. This is your point, right? And the fourth, you can see it as an example, NaCl solution. Like that you can find out the differences. Then what we can see, suspended solution, it's having it as a greater than 1000 nm. The size you are having it as a greater than 1000 nm. It's a non-clear solution. You can say that when you are in place of salt, if I add sand to the water, what will happen? Sand, initially it will make a muddy solution, and then later on, if it is allowed to be settled down for the longer duration, certain sand particles will settle down. all the sands will be collected at the bottom, right? Then it's a non-clear solution. Can be separated by filtration.
Thank you.
pressure forces and also forces of attraction between dispersed phase and dispersed medium. And the third is type of dispersed phase. That is how we are going to get absorbed onto the surface. So we are having three types: physical state, environmental forces, and dispersed particles. One by one, we have to go into the detail of it. So first of all, we will study on the basis of physical state. Now, when we are talking about the physical state, then what will happen? We will be having it as in dispersed phase. You can see it if I want to remember it. The second chapter, types of solutions. Already I told that this is heterogeneous, that was homogeneous. So in the second chapter we already discussed type of the solution on the basis of solid liquid, solid gas, liquid gas, liquid liquid, liquid solid. So, on the basis of physical state of solute and solvent, right? For homogeneous, it was solute, solvent. For heterogeneous, dispersed phase, dispersed medium. You can say that this is solute, this is your solvent, and the type of solution that will be formed. Now, here the word we will be using type of soul that will be formed. Right? Okay. And the fourth one will give it as an examples. So, it is already given in your textbook. A complete table has been formed and it is given to us. If we are having it as a solid, get absorbed onto the solid. It is going to form solid soul. See, for the chapter number 2, solutions, we were having only 3 types: solid solution, liquid solution, gas solution, depending upon the medium. That was a solvent. If your solvent was solid, you will get solid solution. If your solvent was liquid, you got it as a liquid solution. When you got it as a gaseous solvent, we get it as gaseous solution. Here we are going to get it as a different things. We are not having identical conditions like what we were having for the solution. Solid, dispersed phase, solid medium, we got it as a type of solution, soul, that is known as solid soul. You can give it as an example. Color glasses, right? Or you can see it as another example as gemstones. Right? Your girls would be very well knowing about it, that they are fond of artificial diamonds. Green color, blue color, red color, different colors of diamonds are available for the ornaments. Right? Or even in our home also we would be seeing some different glasses. The colors are there. Some is red color, blue color, brown color, or some painting is done, all these things are done. What are they? Nothing else but one component is mixed with other, right? And both of those components are in the solid form, and therefore we got it as solid soul. So that's an example. Another example for it: solid added to liquid, solid phase added in the liquid medium. So this is in large quantity, this is added to it. The adsorption takes place and the formation is known as now simply soul. The component will simply name it as soon. Pins is another example of it. The solid component is added to the liquid and then the painting is done. After a time, what happens? The liquid is vaporized and the solid particles get stuck onto the walls or wherever the painting is done. Right? Even if you are fond of glass painting, can I take it as a glass, solid component and paint on it? No. What we needed is we convert it by adding a water or oil or some organic solvents that are making that component to dissolve in it, and then we are applying as a paint, and then the component, the medium is being vaporized. So you can say that the paint is one of the examples in which dispersed phase is solid, dispersion medium is liquid. The third one, we did the solid gas. The component we will be getting it as that, known as aerosol. The component is known as aerosol. Smoke is an example. From every vehicle the smokes are coming out. We are saying that the carbon particles are coming out. Even at the terminal end of these vehicle exhaust, you can say that the carbon is being stirred. If I hold it, we can see that the carbon becomes black color on our end. What does it show? That means there are some particles which are present in it. They are in mixed in gas. The carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide gases are being exhausted with the carbon particles, unreacted components. So it's known as aerosol. Example, we wrote it as smoke. You can also see dust. When some storms are there, some dust particles, even at your home, when a beam of light is falling from a window, you can see that some dust particles are every time moving here and there. Right? So then dust particles are also mixed in. With the naked eye I can't see it. Can you say that at present around you there is a dust? You will say, no sir, nothing is there. But actually when a beam of light or a particular radiations are allowed in, we can see them very easily. Right? So they are nothing else but solid in a gas. Next one, if my phase is liquid this way, and we are mixing it with solid, then the component form is known as gel. That is haphazard. In our routine life, we are using it, right? Not only haphazard, you can see butter or jelly. The sweets that you are using it, sugar is mixed in it in a liquid form and they get converted into a soft materials, jelly materials, right? So they are known as gels. Liquid mixed in liquid, it forms emulsion. Milk is another example for it. For the emulsion, the milk is an one of the example for it. Liquid mixed in liquid, the component, two different liquids are mixed. They are not homogeneously mixed, heterogeneously mixed. So they are considered to be as an emulsion. Liquid gas, we can think as a thing, aerosol. But for this, the example we are going to get it as cloud. We know it, gaseous component, it's mixed in liquid, that is water. They are forming it as an aerosol, fog, daily. Nowadays, it's very easily observed in the night, nothing is there, but in early in the morning when we wake up and we see our cars or windows or some grass, what we find out? There are the water droplets very easily found on it, right? They are nothing as well because of the fog. Even the visibility becomes difficult, right? For a fraction of time. After that, when the heat increases, that fog is being removed because it gets converted into vapors. So that is being removed. So we get it as gas aerosol. Now the mixing of it, we are having it as a gas mixed with solid. We get it as solid soil. The example here will give it as foam, rubber. We can put it as an example of foam or rubber, which are soft in nature, very easily absorbed, or we can find it. Right? And the last one, gas, liquid. They will be forming it as an again soil. Or particular name for it, foam. Right? So that means now the example becomes much easier for us. We are going to get it as a fruit for it. Right? Here it was a home fruit that can be obtained, or you can see it at home also by adding a detergent into the water and just change it. You will find out the fruit. Right? The ninth one we were having it for the solution, gas in gas. See, we took its solids in solid, liquid, gas. We took it as liquid in solid, liquid and gas. For the gaseous component, we have it as solid and liquid. We don't have the ninth type of it, gas in gas, because gas in gas always produces homogeneous mixture. The name of this is heterogeneous mixture. So that is not being included as a type of it. Right? Today we discussed the first type of the classification based on physical state and of the component. Right? Residue, we will discuss it in our next lecture. But before that, make sure that the table is being clearly done by you. And these are not the limited examples that we are having it. We can have it as a different examples. So you can put the examples. Like you can say it as a whipped cream, right? The cream that has been used, whipping it, it's a type of foam. You can put it over here, the example, whipped cream, it's a type of foam. Similarly, nowadays, the firefighters are not only using it as a water for extinguishing the fires, because some chemical industry over there with the water, they may react very easily. Like if the chemical industry is having it, sodium, and if I add water in it, what will happen? Last minute is to avoid it, we are using carbon dioxide or we are using foam. You would have seen it in the televisions or the Discovery channels or like that, that in a forest, when the forest fire takes place, from the helicopters they are spreading foam, so that the froth that takes place, so that's also the thing as well, it's a type of foam that is being sprayed on it. You can see it in our daily, in our body itself, biological fluids are there, right? Blood itself, one of the example, number of blood cells are there. Can I separate it by normal means? No, it's not possible. I want to go it for some different physical methods, right? But it also contains number of components present in it. So that means you can give it as a biological fluids. They contain large amount of water with it. Not only those components, but the large amount of the water. So biological fluids can also be one of the examples. Like that, number of such examples you can use it, through which you can give it as an example, because in exam they might ask you, some example may be indicated, they may ask you what type of a soul is it, right? In the soul, emulsion is a mixture of liquid dispersed in liquid dispersed medium. They may ask you, what is the difference between gel and soul? This is number of times the question has been asked. What is the difference between gel and soul? In soul, your dispersed phase is solid and medium is liquid. In gel, dispersed phase is liquid and medium is solid. So that's the difference. Phase and medium. Difference between soul and gel. Right? So like that, the examples or the questions can be there. same for you. So it's necessary that we should prepare the complete table, right? Okay, in our next lecture we will discuss about the rest two types. Till then, thank you.